I'm Dr. Angela McBrady of DoctorFlute.com, and today's flute tip is on extended technique, bending pitch. There are a lot of pieces being composed today that use the extended technique of bending your pitch. And it's really not one of the hardest things to do. It's very easy to bend down. It's much harder to bend it up. But there's just a couple little keys to think about when you're bending. If I'm going to bend down, now normally when I am talking about intonation with a student, I don't want them to do flat or sharp by moving their head up and down or rolling in and rolling out. I want them to do it because they know what to do with their embouchure to make it flat or sharp. But all rules go out the window when you're talking about extended techniques. And if I want to bend down, the easiest thing is to both go down with my embouchure and my head. So I'm starting on a G. It's much easier to do that when you use your head, and that's totally allowed. If I'm having a student play in an orchestra and they're saying that they're having a hard time with intonation, we work with a tuner, we learn how to move their airstream, but that's not the case. If you're bending pitch, you just move your head. I would move my head rather than roll in. Although there are times where that is the easier route, so you can use either one. Now, going up, I've definitely had to bend the pitch in an upward direction. And the problem always with going up is that you're starting in your usual embouchure position. If I start in this position, there's very little space for me to go up. I heard just a little bit of a rise there. If you know that coming ahead, you're going to have to move the pitch up, what you have to do is start lower. So if I know that it's coming, I'm going to start lower. And then I can move both roll out and move my head up. Of course, it helps to move your eyebrows up too. It's anticipating what's coming is going to help you with bending up. And it's all on raising that airstream. How can you raise the airstream? Well, you can roll out and you can bring your embouchure up a little bit. But if I start in my normal position, it's hard to go up. It goes up a little bit, but it's not as much of an effect as what I'm looking to do or what a composer might be looking for. Have fun working on your extended techniques. All of them are a lot of fun. And once you learn a skill for a bunch of them, then when you look at a piece that has extended techniques, you're not as afraid starting that piece. Have fun working on bending your pitch, both up and down. That's today's flute tip. If you like this video, press the like button, comment below, share it with your friends, and subscribe.